ba 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 na 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 ba 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 na 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 ba 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 na 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 ba 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 na na to kari no potato ni ka ni maro mani ka no chika ba 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 na na yo plano fu la pano no tu na ba na na la kamo pitala mo ba na na ba 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 na na potato トカリのポタトリカニマロマニカのチカバーバーバーバーナナ
Online. We are so jazzed that you are here with us today on an amazing super day. Now, why do I say that? Because it's Super Bowl Sunday, 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 Sunday. It's Super Bowl Sunday. What could be better?
Wait. I'm ready for it today.
What are you doing?
Bowl, I brought the bowl.
What bowl?
Super bowl. It's a super bowl. Can you imagine how much ice cream you can fit in this guy? Super bowl sundae.
It's not a bowl. It's a Super Bowl, a football game. We've waited all year for these two teams to come and play.
Is this another sport thing?
Yes. It's not a Super Bowl.
This is why we can't just text about stuff. We have to, like, give us a second, guys. Give us a second. You know what, guys? Stand up, get ready to worship, and I'll be right back. Pastor Vince.
Love loses you so. You got L-O-V-E L-O-V-E.
All right, guys. Yeah, okay, Super Bowl Sunday, woohoo, that's awesome. But even more exciting, we are starting a new series this week. It is called What is Love? I know February Love, real original and everything, but I promise it's gonna be a really awesome series. I love to talk about love, especially when we're talking about the Bible. And that's gonna be our theme for the next few weeks. We have a great lesson for you guys today. But before that, check out this video real quick. What do you guys think love is? Let's hear some answers.
Love is like over a gillion stuff.
Helping someone even if you don't want to.
When your parents or your teachers don't tell you to.
Giving away stuff that you really, really like.
If they want the toys, a ship.
Sail. Toys.
It's smiling and saying good things about them.
I should say, you have very nice clothes on.
I hope my mommy.
I played with another person on the playground when she didn't have anybody to play with.
And people that are loving to me, I feel like I should do it to someone else.
Because Jesus did the same for us.
Just like your daughter says you will have them do to you.
That you should treat the other one just like I've been treated before. Not like bad, but the times I've been good treated.
Nobody really wants to play with somebody who's being mean.
Being kind is helping those in need.
Give them some food.
Get fish and bread and green beans and peas and apples.
I'll ask my mom and or dad.
Can we go get food for this hungry person that I found?
Love is
hugging your mom and helping her wash the dishes.
I just get the water thing and just spray them.
People show me love by holding my hand, and they also give me a kiss around the head when I'm asleep very lightly.
There's people that don't get love in other places of the world.
You help them.
Just help people.
If we show people love, they can spread it all around the world.
Okay, come here, Mommy. I'll show her something. I'll show you something. Come here, Mommy.
All right, guys, so in our new series on What is Love, today's lesson, we're talking about one specific type of love called brotherly love, or if you want to get, like, languagey with it, it's phileo love. Brotherly love, the kind of love between siblings, sometimes the love between parents and their kids, things like that. It's, friends, best friends, things like that. So there's a great story in the Bible, in the Old Testament. One guy you know really well, the other guy you might know if you really pay attention to some of the stories. But this first guy, he was a shepherd, then he got real famous from knocking out this real big guy. Okay, you know who I'm talking about. It's David. We're talking about David. But we're also talking about David and his best friend, Jonathan. So let's check out the story real quick and see what happens with these two guys. It's gonna be awesome.
Slapstick Theater, David and Jonathan. This is Jonathan.
Hey!
Who was the son of King Saul and a warrior in Israel's army. This is David.
Hey!
Who would later become the king of Israel.
Huh?
After David defeated a great giant, he was brought before King Saul and he met Jonathan. They immediately became friends.
Yeah!
And Jonathan made a pact with David and showed him that by giving David his robe and weapons.
Oh, hang on.
From that time on, David was successful in all he did.
Arr!
And King Saul became jealous of David and very angry.
Arr.
Saul wanted his servants and Jonathan to get rid of David, but because Jonathan loved his friend David, he warned David of what his father was planning.
Oh, no.
Jonathan went to his father, King Saul, and talked him out of harming David.
Okay.
For a time, David was safe from King Saul's plans.
Phew.
But not long after, the king's jealousy and anger came back, and he tried to kill David.
Whoa!
David got away, and his friend Jonathan came to help him.
I got it.
Jonathan tried again to talk his father out of hurting David.
No.
But now King Saul was convinced he needed David to be gone. Jonathan was angry and sad that his father would not let his friend go. And he knew that David would have to go into hiding and run from King Saul. Jonathan met David one last time, and the two cried and said their goodbyes. Jonathan told David to go in peace and that they had a special bond in God's name. Then David left and lived a life on the run from King Saul, and Jonathan returned to the town. Even though they were separated,
wow, what a crazy story. Now, yeah, it was awesome. A little bit sad, you know, these two best friends can't be best friends anymore because they gotta run away and save their lives and things like that. But still, how awesome was that, that Jonathan was willing to recognize that what his father was doing, not okay. King Saul was being a bad guy now. And that's really sad because he used to love David back before he got famous from the whole Goliath thing. And then now he's trying to kill him, and Jonathan saves his best friend's life by warning him. Now, this was a big deal. The king could have killed Jonathan for basically betraying him for treason. But Jonathan knew that his love for his friend was more important, and David's life was more important. Now, you may not realize this. Jonathan was the son of the king, right? What does that normally mean? Normally, that means he's going to be the next king. But Jonathan was a man of God, and he knew God's blessing, his anointing, was on David, not on himself. And he was willing to step aside from the throne because he knew David was supposed to be the next king of Israel. So this love between him and David, guys, this is some crazy, awesome best friend love. He was willing to set aside his own kingly rights and future for God's anointed man David because he knew the type of man David was. Now y'all might have your own best friend and you know your best friend better than other people do. You know you'd stand up for them. You know you'd do what's right for them and you know what kind of awesome person they are even if sometimes they don't know it. So guys, we learned a great lesson this week all about an aspect of God's love for us, this friendship love, this love that trusts, this love that supports, this love that even defies other people to save your best friend's life. Guys, awesome love, phileo love. Cannot wait to see you guys next week. We're gonna talk about another type of love. It's gonna be real awesome. And of course, next week is Valentine's Day. So get ready for it. And we'll catch you guys then.
Make sure you watch the Super Bowl.
And we'll catch you guys then.